Hello, my dear viewers. How are you all doing? My name is Nirmal Jagan and I am doing pretty good. I am so happy to welcome you to my channel. Today, I am going to share one of the interesting concepts that you need to learn. And the concept is Windows fundamentals. What? As a conventional user, you may ask, we are daily using Windows operating system. Meanwhile, what is the necessity of learning its fundamentals? If you are a conventional, normal user, then the question is valid. But what to do? You and me are not a normal user. We are trying to become an ethical hacker and penetration tester, skillful penetration tester. So obviously, you need to learn operating systems. You have to know what exactly happening inside the machine, how the machine is functioning. So either it can be Linux OS or Windows operating systems, you must know what is happening in that. Particularly, if we say desktop operating systems, then 70% of systems are running Windows. So, which is huge. Out of 100 systems, 70 systems are running Windows operating system. So obviously, Windows is essential if you are penetration tester. But don't worry, I am here to share that I learned few concepts in Windows. So I'm so glad to share those concepts with you. And also, I am not gonna overwhelm you with bunch of Windows contents in a single video. Instead, I plan to split this video into few parts. So you will be witnessing a series of Windows fundamentals from me. You should have heard this statement. The Linux operating system is more secure than Windows operating system. Do you know why? I'll tell you. There are few reasons. I'll tell you the more important reason here. You should have heard the term malware. The software which is developed to do some unwanted malicious things. So if someone can write a legitimate software to an operating system, then obviously they can able to write some malicious software as well. So as a Windows defender, as a cyber defender, you must learn Windows operating system. So in this video, I am gonna explain the evolution of Windows and it's basic the file system. Let me explain how it evolved. So let me explain about the Windows desktop operating systems. It has a long history. In 1985, Microsoft introduced their first ever operating system called MS-DOS, Disk Operating System. The user interface is very different from the current operating systems that we are using. In MS-DOS, the operating system is CLI. There is no GUI interface, graphical user interface. Everything is command line. So you must know the appropriate commands to interact with the machine. So that is not flexible enough for the users, and it had a few updated versions, the MS-DOS. Later, they introduced Windows 95. It's an updated operating system version, which introduced the internet compatibility very first time. So it came up with the Internet Explorer web browser. So it gave the internet connectivity to that operating system, to that machine. So after that, they launched Windows XP. I'm just talking about the desktop operating systems. Windows XP. Still, most of us can remember how popular the Windows XP was. It was a popular operating system and it had a long run also. Windows XP had a long run. After that, they introduced operating system called Windows Vista. it's short-lived. It didn't get much attention from its users, so it went short-lived. And after that, Microsoft announced the end of life for Windows XP. Most of the institutions, most of the normal computer users shocked due to that info. And immediately after that information, Microsoft managed to release the next version of Windows operating system. And comparatively, it is also a popular operating system. It is nothing but Windows 7. And it gained so many users. And after Windows 7, they introduced Windows 8. Like Windows Vista, Windows 8 also a short-lived version. So it didn't gain much much attention and it didn't get through. It was short-lived. Later in 2015, Windows 10 was introduced. Currently, we are using Windows 10 operating systems only, and most of the users accepted this Windows 10, and it is popular operating system that we are currently using. And in recently, last month, Microsoft announced its next operating system is called Windows 11. So it is like in a testing phase. So most of the users needs to be all of the users must be switched to Windows 11 before the Windows 10 obsoleted. When we are talking about Windows desktop operating systems, we cannot simply ignore the servers, Windows servers, which is another interesting product of Microsoft. The first server version was released in 1993, and the version is called Windows NT 3.1 Advanced Server. And it came up with the application, the feature like Internet Information Services, the web server solution in Windows Server, and other networking protocols and some administrative wizards. Windows NT Server got few updates in the span of 7 years. After 7 years, in 2000, Windows released their next server operating system, and the version is Windows 2000 Server. It introduced Active Directory. So the Active Directory debuted in Windows 2000 Server. Along with the Active Directory, Microsoft also introduced a solution called MMC, Microsoft Management Console. And by the way, when I'm explaining each and every server, I may be mentioning some of its features. So no need to worry. I'll explain those features in detail when we are diving deep into Windows operating system concepts. And the next version, after Windows 2000, they introduced Windows 2003 server version. And it came up with the firewall technology, first of all. It came up with the firewall technology. Along with that, it also introduced a feature called Volume Shadow Copy Service. So it's a backup mechanism. I'll explain it in detail in upcoming videos. After Windows 2003, they introduced a server version called Windows 2008. In Windows 2008 server, they introduced the failover mechanism, to adding two servers in cluster, and virtualization mechanism, and also they made some enhancements in its Active Directory feature. And after Windows 2008, Microsoft came up with various server versions like Windows 2012, Windows 2016, and most recently Windows came up with its version, its server Windows 2019. So, which is the latest Windows server that we are currently using. The Windows 2019 server came up with the particular, the features like Kubernetes and Linux containers. So these are the particular some exciting features that they introduced with Windows 2019 server. So this is all about the evolution of Windows desktop operating systems and Windows server operating systems. Now, let me share my screen and showcase how a Windows operating system interface will look like. Even I am running Windows operating system only in my base machine, but I am not showcasing that machine. Instead, I am leveraging the feature of Hack the Box Academy. So it offers the courses, the free courses, so you can learn a few of its courses by using the credits they are giving to you. So I enrolled the Windows course, so this is where I learned all those fundamentals. And it also, along with the course content, it offers the free, and also along with the course content, it offers the free machine. So I spawned my machine here, so I can download the VPN key and I can take that machine in control. So like that, I took the control of my target machine. So this is the basic Windows machine that we need to learn. So whenever you install an operating system, the Windows operating system, it looks like this, particularly the Windows 10. So this is the home page. It is called desktop, and you can see the list of applications here. So it is called the task. The bar is called taskbar. So the list of applications that you are often using, you can store it here. And you can see the search bar here. So if you need to grab some contents from the machine, you can simply type it and you can get whatever you want from that operating system. So it is running based on a feature called Cortana, okay, Cortana. And the next thing is, you can see the small window icon. So this is called start button. So when you click this, it will pop up the list of application that the operating system, the machine contains. I can scroll down and I can choose whatever application that I want. And from here, can you see the gear icon? The gear icon represents the settings. So you can click this and you can explore its various settings and you can customize however you want. Okay. And apart from this, let me walk you through its file system. This is the image called, this is the application called File Explorer. I just opened it. So when you open this, you will be able to see an icon called this PC. So when you click this, you will be able to see the list of disks that an operating system is having. It's a Windows system, right? So the default operating system disk is named as C. So if you learn Linux, you can see a path, a directory path called /. So it is the beginning path of the entire file system of Linux. Similarly, the file system, the Windows file system, starts with the disk C. So this is where it begins. If I open, I can see few folders here. So each and every folders are quite important to run the Windows operating system. So let me explain what is the role of each and every folder given here. The first folder we are seeing is Academy. It is not a specific default folder in Windows operating system. So it's a custom folder created in this specific machine. So when I open this, I'll be able to see the flag file. So it is like capturing the flag. And so if we can ignore this, and the next one is performance logs. So mostly this particular folder should be empty in many cases, but it might store some Windows performance logs. And the next folder is program files. And also you can see the similar folder, program files, and an into mark and 86. There is a difference between these two folders. Let me explain that. If I click this PC, you need to right click and go to the properties. We will be able to find some crucial information about the operating system. It is Windows operating system, and you can see the system type. It is 64-bit operating system and 64-based processor. So you can also call it as an architecture of the system. So if you need to understand this concept, 64 and 32-bit operating system in deeper, then you might need to study this architectures in depth. Now the system is 64-bit system, hence any applications that you are installing which is for 64-bit systems, then those applications will be installed in this program files folder. And what about this program files into 86? It means 32-bit. So if any applications that was created for 32-bit operating system, then we can also run that application, but those applications will be stored inside this 86 folder. So these two folders contain the list of applications installed on the machine. And the third folder is user. Let's see what is present inside that. I can see a few folders here. STB-student, a folder for specific user. So now I logged in this machine as STB-student. So I got a folder created for me, and I also have few other folders inside my user folder. And apart from that, I have one more user folder, MRB3N. And apart from that, I have a folder called default user 0. When I click this, it is asking me to continue. So when I continue, I got few folders: desktop, documents, downloads, favorites. You can see the same folders here. So whenever a user profile is created on Windows, Windows also create the list of folders listed here in default. So whenever a new user is created, it simply uses this template. That is how the list of desktop, download, documents folders created for STB student and MRB3N, I mean other Windows users. And the next folder, public. When I click this, I can see the same name, documents, downloads, music, but it has the prefix public, which means whenever we put some contents inside these public folders, then these contents will be shared among its users, I mean the machine's other users as well. So that is the purpose of this public folder. Now let me explain about a crucial folder, Windows. So you can see bunch of folders inside this, and when you open a folder, we will be able to see n number of files, and these files are very, very, very critical, and these files are completely responsible for Windows operating system. So without a proper knowledge, you should not mess in this folder. So it will screw up your entire operating system. So keep that in mind, which is very, very important. And we also got a few other important folders here, and I'll explain all those applications present inside this folder in detail in upcoming videos. Okay, and we see few folders, totally 5 folders here, and we have few other folders, and those folders are hidden. If you need to unhide those folders, then you need to go to view and options. Here we can see in view tab hidden files and folders. Now currently the hidden option is chosen. We need to change that. When I click show hidden files, folders and drive and apply, it will list all those hidden folders. In hidden folders, I can see one folder. You can see the folder is faded out, program data. And to be honest, a normal user has nothing to do with this program data, but we can see the list of folders which is named individual applications running on this machine. So The data contained within these folders are used by the applications running on this particular machine. So this folder is totally used by the applications, not by the users. So you need to understand this as well. So whenever you are logging into a machine, whenever you are getting access to a machine, you need to know where you need to navigate to get some juicy information. And Windows system, the Windows operating system is more popular because of because how easy it is to use. Even a general normal user who doesn't have any experience in IT can able to navigate this machine easily by using the Windows. So that is the beauty of Windows operating system. Along with the GUI, Windows is also offering its command line interface solution called Command Prompt. So this is the Command Prompt, which is not same but almost similar to the MS-DOS disk operating system introduced as the first operating system. So by using some commands, we will be able to perform certain tasks on this operating system. Let me scroll a little bit. I can see the prompt here. So I'll be able to fetch few information by using simple commands. For example, let me use a command called ipconfig. When I use ipconfig, it will list the network adapter information. So currently the machine's IP address is 10.129.16.2209, and along with this machine's IP address, it also displays the default gateway and its IPv6 address and even its DNS suffix. Even we can use this command with few other suffixes to get more detailed info. For example, let me use ipconfig/all. The keyword is all. If I use this, I'll be able to see some more details, like the DHCP server from where the machine is receiving the IP and the DNS details. DNS detail is very, very important to reach the internet. When you are using the domain name, the DNS server will resolve it as IP address. Okay, this is all about some basic commands. If you don't have any idea about what command should be used, then you may use, for example, let me say I want to use ipconfig, but I need to see certain information, but I have no idea what is the suffix command. In that case, you can give /, and ? Just enter. It will list the available options. It is same as the help feature and the man page feature available on Linux operating systems. Okay, let me introduce one more command. The command is tree. The command is used to view the hierarchy of a particular file or a folder. So the command is simple. The keyword is tree. After that, you need to mention the path of a particular file. So I copied a path. All I need is to paste that path after the word tree and make sure it is present inside the double quotes because of the spaces in this path. We good to go. When I give enter, I can able to see the volume serial number, the folder path. It listed the path of the Windows PowerShell folder. So this is how it looks like. You can see everything begins here in C folder. So it's the origin. As I said before, C folder is like / folder in Linux operating systems. So sometimes the results may be larger than you expect. So be ready for that. When we say about the file systems, there are so many concepts that I can explain. I'll explain those concepts in the subsequent videos. So stay tuned. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you really did, consider subscribing my channel, and you can also share this video among your friends, so it would be very helpful for them to prepare for penetration testing and ethical hacking. Yeah, that's all I had to say. I'll catch you up with the subsequent video of Windows Fundamentals. Until then, signing off. Take care. Bye, guys.